You know, I've been fishing with an awful lot of people through all these years. I fished with guides all over the continent. I got to tell you, Will is not only one of the finest guides that I've ever fished with. Maybe it's because he's such a great fisherman, but I think it's also because he grew up in these waters. He knows these waters tremendously, but there's an awful lot more to it than just that. When you go fishing with Will, you have a fabulous time. And here's the thing that you can really look forward to in a day's fishing here on the reservation. Number one, you're going to catch an awful lot of fish, and you have the option of catching big smallmouth, big largemouth bass. And for New York State, I'm talking some pretty big bass. 6-pounders are not uncommon, and I know there's been bigger ones, but I don't want to get your expectations way up there. You've got wonderful northern pike fishing. I mean, just school after school of northern pike. Walleyes, which we haven't fished as much just because we prefer fishing some of these other species, but a lot of people come up here and that's what they want to fish, the walleyes, because there's so many here. And finally, to me, the king of all fish, muskies. You know, people have been very interested in the St. Lawrence River and the muskie fishing here for years because of its reputation, because of the tremendous muskie fishery that there is. But what they don't realize is these rivers flowing into the St. Lawrence have these muskies, yet they don't have the fishermen. And these muskies actually grow old, never seeing a fisherman's lure. And Will has a section of the river here, of the St. Regis River, that goes through the reservation area that I believe is some of the finest muskie fishing in the world. And you spend a day floating down this river in a big John boat that Will has fishing for muskies, and I'll tell you what, you're going to remember it for life. But those are your options. You've got a lot of options. And I guess the most important thing of all is you're spending it with a person that's a blast to be with, that's a fabulous teacher, and finally is a wonderful fisherman. So you're going to catch fish, you're going to have fun, and you're going to go away just counting the days till you can return. You know, I think this is something that we all should think more about. And that's our options. A lot of times we'll go out and we'll say, well, the fish aren't hitting or the conditions are just terrible. And that's really something that we faced here. We came up the river to fish for smallmouth bass and we found ourselves in a flooded, muddy, turbulent mess. And my thought is, gosh, well, there is no way in this world those fish are going to hit anything. Number one, they're not going to see anything. Number two, they're so disrupted from this sudden change that they're not going to be on the bite. But Will says, no, we'll get something with color, and I think they will. And sure enough, he chose a white spinnerbait. Now, we tried a number of other things with no strikes, but by going to a white spinnerbait with a blade that's going to flash, it's going to vibrate, it's going to create sound, and you got that white, that very visible color out there, it did the trick. And, you know, that was a huge lesson for me, and it really should be a lesson for you that, you know, we're never really out if we think and if we go to all the options that we've been taught about and that we've tried before. Just always be remembering there's usually some way. Now, I want to show you something else about this bait that's pretty interesting, because in fishing smallmouth in the current here, a lot of the strikes would occur, especially on this tail, and we'd miss the fish. So what we did was we went to a trailer hook, and you can do this very easily. And, Will, why don't you get up here and you can explain why that was a good method for us to do that, because you're the one that put this trailer hook on here, and explain why you put it on in that manner.
Okay, well, what we've done here is I put the trailer hook on and I've left the trailer hook loose. Because what happens here is when you put this keeper, most trailer hooks, they come with a keeper. A lot of people will slide the trailer hook right inside the keeper and then put it on. But what that does is it makes the hook really stiff. When a smallmouth or any bass bites it, it gives them, like, you know, when he's trying to throw the bait, it gives him more leverage to throw the bait. As of when it's riding free, it just flops around. So when he's going like this and throwing it in his mouth, he can't get the leverage as much to throw the spinnerbait out of his mouth. And plus with this stinger hook, people call it trailer hook, you get a lot of bass that'll short strike your bait. And what that means is when they come up to the top of the surface or when you're swimming your bait through the water, they'll come up and they'll short strike it. They keep missing it. But what this does is it gives you the extra hook in the back so that when they come up, they're going to short strike the tail, short strike the body, but they're not going to short strike the hook that's sticking out. So when they come up behind it, instead of getting the main hook, they get the trailer hook.
Tell you what, this is the absolute beauty of fishing in this area, and also of going out with an open mind and being able to change your bait to the conditions. Now, we've come out. Boy, the water's clear in the St. Lawrence, and look at this hog of a smallmouth that I've caught, or that I've hooked here, on a bucktail jig. And there's a reason I picked a bucktail jig, because we're fishing in fairly strong current in crystal clear water, and I wanted something that I could get down a bit. Oh, isn't that a beauty? St. Lawrence River smallmouth on the bucktail. Holy cow. That is a trophy fish. And, it's really interesting because I haven't used a bucktail all day. And I chose this lure, a lure that most of you have never used, would never use because you'd think it wouldn't work. It's one of the greatest lures ever invented because it has a profile of a minnow, it has a coloration of a minnow, it's a bugginess of a fly, and you can make it do whatever your mind makes you think you can do because it's pretty neutral. So it's a wonderful lure. Anyway, we'll get that huge bass back in the water.
Let's get him back in there.
Oh,
nice fish, real nice fish.
Boy, that's wonderful. That is wonderful. You know, a lot of times you say, well, I don't care if the fish gets off. I really wanted that fish to stay on because I wanted to show all of you what beautiful smallmouths there are. So, here's what we've shown you today. We've shown you bucktail jigs. We've shown you worms. We've shown you horny toads. We've shown you spinner baits. And we tried other things that didn't quite work. You know, people ask me, well, what are you going to use? What are you going to use? And like I've always said, I let the fish tell me what I'm going to use. Fishing is an awful lot of fun. Here's another thing to take with you the next time you go.